Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this brown box, making sure I've got it up the right way. This is the Ubiquiti Cloud Gateway Max, the UCG Max, all right? So just to confuse it, there are plenty of things. The UXG Max, now there is the UCG Max, all right? The Unifi Cloud Gateway Max. What is this? Well, it's not going to be a big technical overview. I want to show you what's in the box. There's plenty of other videos on our YouTube channel on what do I need to run the Cloud Gateway Max, or rough and ready on the Cloud Gateway Max if you want to see a little bit more of performance and things like that. So let me run you through what you're going to get in the box. First, you are going to get your little get started guide, which you're probably not going to actually do anything with. You are going to get a little ether lighting cable. Now, I was quite excited about this because I thought maybe at the back of the unit was some ether lighting ports, but no, it's not. But you get a 30 centimeter ether lighting cable. You are going to get a packet of little feet there for the bottom of it. You're going to get your quick release tool. Why? Because this has got a built-in SSD drive, an MVNE drive, which I'll talk to you again and show you that in a moment. You are going to get a full power pack for it. It's got an IEC, we call it like the Mickey Mouse ears, probably if you have it up that way, looks like it, and it's USB-C on this side. And then you're going to get a power cable for your region. I'm here in Australia, so Australian on that end. And there we've got our IEC Mickey shape one on there. And then we had the unit itself. All right, you probably looked at this and think, oh, this is quite similar, because over here I actually have, round the other way, I have the Cloud Gateway Ultra. Pretty much identical, same form factor and everything else like that. The differentiator that we have here on this is our drive bay here on the side, which we'll have a look at. So the Cloud Gateway Max, what's its significant thing? This runs all of the Ubiquiti applications. So this can run Protect, this can run Ubiquiti Network, it can run Access, it can run Identity. So the whole suite can be run off this. There are many versions that you can have. There's a no storage version. The one we're looking at today has got 512 gig of RAM, but they are all upgradable. I'm going to show you quickly how you can do that as well. So let me just run you through this now. So obviously the front, we've got a small LCD screen on the side. Over here is where our NVMe goes in, which we'll have a look at in a moment. You can see underneath here, we've got air cooling vents. Which way are we going? This way around. All right, we have got all of these here are 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet ports. We've got one WAN and four LAN. That's the difference there from your Cloud Gateway Ultra, that you can see you've only got one 2.5 gigabit a second port on there. We did speed test this with iPerf and our own in-house server, which can do 10 gigabits a second. We actually found this to do about 1.7 and 1.8 gigabits a second of throughput. And even with IPS intrusion prevention turned on, that really didn't drop by more than about 100 megasecond. Smart queues is another thing that people ask about. We turned on smart queues. The maximum you can run a smart queue to is 1 gig. And again, the unit still delivered that 1 gig. You'll see we've got a small reset hole over here as well. On the top's just the logo, if I put it up the right way. Really, that is all there is to the unit. Like I said, it can run everything. So let me just give you a quick run through of what we can actually do on the inbuilt hard drive. Why do we have the inbuilt hard drive? Well, the inbuilt hard drive is going to give us storage for things like Unifi Access and Unifi Protect, where we're storing logs and everything information. Obviously, if it's Unifi Protect, it's where we're storing all our video footage. And I would say that this is probably going to be good for about 10 cameras, something like that. I think maybe if you're doing 4K cameras, it will push it a little bit further down, maybe between 5 and 8, I guess. But we truly haven't tested these out yet to be able to see the full performance, and I'm sure that will come over time. So I've just taken our quick little release tool here, and we can push this into the side of our unit. So like I said, you might buy this already with a RAM built into this. Let's just pop that open and take that out. All right, so here we go. This is the card itself. It is fully self-serviceable. I'll just reach over here for the screwdriver. It does use like a star. I don't know whether that will, maybe it will focus a little bit. It does use a star tool at the end, so you might need to use that. So all we're just gonna do here is take off the cover. There we go, just run this screw out. Now, in here by standard is a, I believe it is a 2280 formatted, or format, NVMe, SSD drive. All right, now it looks like you can take multiple different formats in here because there's screw holes all the way through, as you can see at the bottom. I believe there's another format as well, but we've stuck with the NVMe 228 format. So I'm just going to again undo this screw here. If you've obviously bought the no storage model, then you're just going to have this tray empty and it's not actually going to have anything in it at all. So we take that screw out, all right, and we can actually now release our card. This comes with a 512 Kingston built into it in the drive model that we've got. Let me just pop that aside. We're going to swap this for a good quality. We're going to put the Samsung 990 Pro model in. This is a 2 terabyte, should be no issue going higher. There's a 4 terabyte Samsung drive that's done, and this, so again, it's the same format, it should fit in and work. So you can see there's our card, just hold that up. So again, all we're going to do is, we've got lineup holes and everything in here, wants to show you where to put it, and we can again see I've put it upside down because I'm trying to look in the camera at the same time. There we go, so we're just going to pop that through into place, and it just pushes down and it solidly fits there, as you can see. And now we can just put our screw back into there. That's our screw going back in, as you can see. And we can just put our plate back over the top. Now, it does run warm. Obviously, the higher RAM sizes you have in here, it does run that somewhat warmer. So we pop that into place again. And then we can just again put our final retaining screw, if I can do this here, while holding it up. Let's just have a little look there. All right, so that's going back into place now. There we go. All right, so we've now upgraded this. Obviously, do this with the power off on the device. We can see our vacant hole in there. So like I said, I've used an NVMe. This is a Samsung 990 Pro, 2 terabyte in the 2280 format. So as long as I've got this up the right way, we should just be able to pass that back in and clip that into place. And that is our unit actually upgraded. So hopefully that's been useful. Just have a quick look again. LCD screen on the front, cooling vents on the bottom, 2.5 gigabit a second. You can have 2 WAN connections to this, your primary and your secondary, and it will do load balancing and failover between those. So hopefully that's been useful. Why don't you head on over to our YouTube channel? Plenty more box openings on network firewall and wireless devices. Plenty more how-to guides, like I've said, on, you know, what do I need to run this, or how do I set it up as well. So head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.